Hey guys, Zach here. Make sure you like and subscribe if you want more videos. I'm going to show you a new product called the PICO Syringe. It actually took place of another product for arterial blood gases, venous blood gases, and some pleural fluid. So if you remember these kits, they're actually located in the clean utility room. They come in a pretty bulky package, Band-Aid, prep, orange needle. And if you I open it up here, you're going to notice a small little wafer. When I used to open these up, you'll notice that there's a lure lock. So we were able to hook these up to our lock and pull off our venous blood gases pretty easily. Today, there's gonna be a little bit of a challenge when it comes to the new product. So let me get into the new product now. When you go into the clean utility where these kits are located, or where they were located, you're gonna see a plastic bag that's located like this. You'll also see next to it, we're gonna have syringes by themselves. We'll have two different types, one with a needle, one without a needle. And this one comes with a pack with several items in there that could help you. Gauze, bandages, bag, things like that. So just remember, depending on what you grab, you might need to bring other things to the bedside. Okay? New product itself, once we open it up, I'm gonna show it to you brand new out of the package here. We'll have two pieces. You'll have your actual barrel, syringe, and needle. At the very bottom, you're also gonna see the cap. Like so. Okay, set that right there. Okay. You'll also notice that if I without the needle, you might have a device that looks like this. That just comes right out of the package and it looks just like a small syringe with a little lure lock. And you're gonna notice right here that this is a dark color. The other one might be a light gray color. They all work the same way. The darker color actually has a pre-filling mechanic that when I poke, as long as I set it up to where I'm at, 1 milliliter, 1.5, 2, it'll draw back the blood when they poke the artery. And then it'll draw back into there. So these are all used for ABGs, arterial blood gases, and VBGs, venous blood gases. If you look inside of there, you're actually gonna see a small ball and you're gonna see a wafer. That heparin wafer has 4 times the amount of heparin as our normal product, so keep that in mind. But it'll actually be less clotting when they take it up to the lab. Okay? So a couple things that you could actually draw. Now, if you grab the product as is and you unsheath the needle, you could technically, without having to set up another butterfly set to attach the needle and poking them and drive, you could technically use this needle, poke the vein, and draw back the blood that you needed, okay? So in that example, I have my vein, I palpate it, I poke, okay? I get the blood. You'll notice on the very top, there's a small hump. If I just press that down and in, it actually activates a safety and clicks. Once I do that, I'm safe to disengage. If you notice, I disengage with a twist and a pull, okay? Once I'm out, you'll notice that this product looks exactly like the other product that we'll have by the syringe without the needle. You'll notice something about this. There's no blood in this one, but if there was blood and air, if I cap it like so, so cap, little twist, I can expel the air up, leaving just the blood. So then you would label it with your beaker label. If you're not gonna send it up within seconds, you can actually swish it around and you'll notice that ball moves around. That's actually how the machine mixes it up for the gas and mix it up like so. You would label it, put it on ice, send it upstairs. This is for a venous blood gas, for a venous pH. That's a totally different test. And a venous pH is gonna be a green on ice that you have to call the lab. So remember, they say venous blood gas, you're gonna grab this syringe cap. A couple of different things too. So I already mentioned that you could poke using the needle that's on there. I also mentioned message that you could take this syringe with a butterfly, slip it on there and set up with a butterfly. You also, if things were really rough and you had another option, you could actually draw the blood out with a normal syringe, put a needle on that syringe. Don't worry, this isn't a real needle, guys. A needle on the syringe. And you could actually insert it into the tip of the PICO and you could expel the blood like so. Kind of like how you could do blood cultures like that as well. The reason I mention these things is because if you look at the actual product, it's no longer a lure lock, okay? Yeah, I know, right? It's not a lure lock. So the issue is that when I have my angiocath in my patient, I can slip the angiocath directly in and draw my blood if I wanted to. But if I try to simulate a lock inside the patient, right, you have to use a two-hand method. So what you would do is you would take your PICO syringe, you would insert it into the top of the lock. You're gonna hold the bottom of the lock with your palm, your forefinger with the top of the lock, and now I'm secured, I'm not going anywhere. Then you could draw back the blood from the lock and let go. The reason for that is this is actually slipping. It's a slip lock. So it's not meant to screw, it's supposed to slip. So there's no way that it's gonna stay in there. So by using the two-handed method in the palm and the forefingers, I can have more control over that. This also is designed to be able to use a safe set to draw from an arterial line. So with that being said, if I have my arterial line, okay, this is what I'm talking about, a safe set. Okay, it's literally a port on the end, a non-coring needle. It's actually a piece of plastic. And then if I show you on the end of the art line, there's a port, okay? If I insert this port over the line, it actually activates in it. So when I stopped my blood with the art line, which I'll show you in another video, but by the art lines, I can then take my PICO syringe, insert it with a little twist, and it does not come out. Now I can draw arterial blood gases from an art line, okay? All right, I hope you liked what you saw. Please reach out to me, email me, shoot me a text, let me know what you want me to do next. I'm gonna shoot another video here soon. It should be out in a little bit later this day or this week. We're gonna do ENFit syringes, and I'm gonna show you all the new product lines. All right, thank you.